Workers in Berks is supported by Southeastern PA Area Labor Federation.
Good evening and welcome to this month's Workers in Berks program. Joe and I are honored to have these special guests. We're going to get right to them. Stamp out hunger, baby. But first, a commercial from the United Labor Council. I want to thank Bob Hoffmaster and the Southeast Labor Federation, the United Labor Council, and all the officers. We're going to have our annual Union Appreciation Picnic. That's going to be Saturday, May 6th, just a month away, less than a month away, actually, at the Reading State Philly Stadium in the pool area. There'll be no game, so we'll have the whole stadium to ourselves. Heated pool, family-friendly buffet, only $45 a ticket. That's a bargain.
Will folks. I be able to run the bases, Mike?
I don't know. I have to ask.
We had some folks on the field last year.
But we'll have the whole stadium to ourselves. So if you're interested, please call the Reading Berks United Labor Council, 610-374-2725. $45 May 6th, Saturday. Starts at 6 p.m., 610-374-2725. So, Joe, why don't you introduce our guests? One of these guests needs no introduction, but let's introduce them anyway, Joe.
We are honored on a few levels today to not only have two outstanding representatives of the Postal Service, two union letter carriers, two leaders, but Richie McDonough is very familiar to any viewer here. For 20 years, in the neighborhood of 20 years, he hosted this show. And Mike, I know you've done many more shows than I have in the area of chess and whatever. Have you been 20 years yet, Mike?
I'm not sure. Not quite that. But quite. This is Yoda.
He trained
all the Jedi Knights.
Richie is what and when it comes to Workers in Berks, I remember watching the show many years with George Cook, Richie, your good friend and co-host. And you guys just set the bar too high for us, but we are trying respectfully to keep a show running. So, we always appreciate you very much being here. And we also have Tammy Jones with us, and Richie and Tammy are both going to talk about not only the Postal Service later, but we really want to focus on this fabulous fundraiser, which I'll let you guys talk about more, Stamp Out Hunger, and this service to the community. So why don't one of you give us the best background of that and give us some maybe how it started and how it functions. And we'll ask some questions along the way to clarify it.
Okay, great. Well, first off, thanks for the very nice words, you know, which I certainly don't deserve. It's an honor for me and privilege for me to be with you two guys. You know, because I know you guys, you live on the altruistic plane, right? You know what I'm saying, Mike?
Thank you.
And, you know, always doing good work, and that's what this show's all about, you know, Workers in Berks, and I used to say, in their families, and that's what this is all about, and that's like what Tammy and I are here to talk about tonight. It's really nice to be here. It's weird being a guest, but we're here. We're both members of the National Association's Letter Carriers, local branch 258, the best branch in the country. And we're basically mailmen. I don't deliver mail anymore. I stopped in 2017. I do just strictly union work. Tammy, goes out and works 60 hours a week.
Wow.
At least, right?
Yep.
And then she gives. to work for her fellow carriers and spends all her energy and time, like we all do as union people, helping other people. And that's what we do. And what we're going to talk about today is one of the biggest, well, it's one of the biggest way to help our community. And as letter carriers and, you know, we go out there, we're out there every day in this year, and especially over the pandemic. And I got to tell you, these gals and guys who went out there, they were working 7 days a week, right, Tim?
Correct.
7 days a week, essential workers out there through, like, they have not had a break. They're exhausted, you know, and then not only do they work 7 days a week, what, 70, 80 hours a week, you know, during a once-in-a-lifetime pandemic, hopefully.
Sure.
And then they go and we do other stuff, you know, and to help our carriers and also to help the community. As a male person, obviously, we spend the majority of our time out there in the community.
Yeah.
You know?
Well, you're on the ground. So when you talk about fighting hunger, you must hear stories and probably know from your own experience what you see in our neighborhoods and what the needs are and the communication that so many of you and your coworkers have had with folks who have these needs.
And being out there that much, Joe and Mike and Tammy will tell you that the letter carriers are the eyes and the ears of the community.
Yes.
Right, Tammy? And we watch kids grow up. I'm meeting my customers' grandchildren now. I know their families. I know their names. I've had dinner with them. Tammy has too. We know where we see the kids running around the street without a jacket in the wintertime, you know, and it's heartbreaking.
Yep.
You know, so this is one of many things that as letter carriers, especially as National Association of Letter Carriers, that we do. So I'm going to let Tammy talk because I could talk forever on this stuff.
It's a great thing.
You know, so tell us about the drive and what it supports.
This is the 31st year of the food drive. Okay. It is always the second Saturday in May. And what the carriers do, we have a lot of volunteers, retired and active members in our branch that help out for that day. We drive around on that Saturday. We go out and collect foods in the neighborhood, bags, which I brought a sample of a bag here. This is a paper bag that you will see in your mailboxes coming up the beginning of May. We also do food drive cards here that go out prior to the bags as a little reminder to our customers what's going to be happening on May 13th, which is that's the day of the food drive. It's just a really important event for us, a very giving day for us. We start usually like 8 o'clock in the morning, and a lot of times we're going like 13 hours that day.
Fabulous.
Emptying the trucks. All our food goes to Helping Harvest, which is over in Sinking Springs, so all donations go directly to them.
Great organization.
Yes.
One of you give a little background to the viewers about Helping Harvest? Or?
Okay, Helping Harvest, which used to be the Greater Berks Food Bank, because I remember when it was on Neversink Street.
Right.
And just a great, great organization. And I think it's 1 in 8 Americans, what they call food insecure, are hungry nowadays, and a large percentage of that are children. You know, here's the people, you know, what we're doing for, we're collecting food for the most vulnerable of our neighbors. Okay. Basically, in Berks County, I think it's something like 24,000 kids or 38,000 kids, something like that, are hungry. Kids. Mm-hmm. You know, and then a large percentage in the United States, like 5 million senior citizens.
Yep.
You know, and these are very vulnerable people. And another large percentage that I don't have the numbers for are our military vets. Mm. Like these are the most vulnerable people, and we don't think about it. You know, and especially after the pandemic and shortage of food, it's really difficult out there. And nobody should ever go hungry, especially a kid or somebody who spent their whole life working and contributing to this community into this country, that they go hungry. You know, when they go hungry, it's the kids, they, you know, like that affects their ability to learn.
Absolutely.
You know that, Mike,
absolutely.
Right?
Absolutely.
They can't concentrate, they can't study. Seniors, it makes them vulnerable to dementia, to diabetes. So, like, this is so important, you know, and the numbers are staggering, you know. As mailmen, we have a good job. We fight really hard for wages and benefits, and we make a good living wage, and we're one of the few, and we're really grateful for that. So to be able to give back, you know, and it just makes me insane that these people go hungry. So the Help and Harvest, you know, runs, distributes the food throughout Berks and Schuylkill County. They have like 320 different agencies, like food banks,
mobile stations,
pantries, and some wonderful programs. Like I think 12% of the people in Berks and Schuylkill counties go hungry or are food insecure, whatever the appropriate political thing is. And so they have these different programs. Specifically, they have programs for kids and for seniors. And one of the programs is the backpack with the Weekender program, where they pack, because these kids, they come to school, and there's such a large percentage that are eligible for reduced lunches.
That's an outstanding point. And you know, Richie, we're all Berks Countyans.
Yeah.
And sometimes we have an idea where pockets of poverty are. And we're all wrong when we think that, aren't we?
Right.
Because even the wealthiest school districts in this county have significantly high levels of kids on the lunch program.
Right.
And thank God for that during the week. But what a great program to get
the
food on a weekend.
These weekend programs feed kids from Wyomissing, Shillington,
everywhere.
Name it.
Everywhere.
Everywhere. It's just not, you know, the city gets a bad rap.
Yeah.
But no, it's huge.
It's every district.
Every district. And this is really important because the kids who depend on these lunches during the week, what do they do on the weekends? They go home and they starve.
Yep.
Unless, you know, there was programs such as this. And they have an equivalent to that one for senior citizens. I forget the name of it.
It's so nice. And Tammy, you must feel this way on your route when you know that this is going right. We're collecting from our community, but you guys are giving right back to
Correct.
The community.
Right. And I do want to also mention that we do have Visions Credit Union that sponsors our bags. So that is a big help. A few years ago, we didn't have bags.
Okay.
And once we had somebody that was sponsoring our bags, our numbers tripled.
Right. So
in what we
and I can't say enough for Visions for doing this. And now I'm a Visions member, and I have been, and as is my family, because I'm not going to tell you how much they cost, but it's a lot of money to get these bags.
Yeah.
And so on a normal basis, I think we'd collect, say, 30,000 pounds. When we have these bags, we collect 130,000.
Wow. Right. Makes it easy for the customers.
Correct.
Huh? And there's two kinds of bags.
It makes it so,
this is a colorful one.
Visual.
Maybe hold that up.
This was our bag last year that we did.
Okay.
The plastic.
Mm-hmm. The plastic. We are going to be doing paper bags this year, but you may see the blue bags in the boxes.
Sure.
Yeah, we're going to use both. And the beauty of this is, somebody said, simple. It's the beauty is in its simplicity, right? So this isn't hard, you know, go through your cupboards, even go to the store and buy a few things. All you have to do, and it's very important, that non-perishable, no glass, non-perishable, no frozen foods, no, you know, produce or anything like that. And all you have to do is fill a bag, and you can put any kind of bag. If you want to put a bag, a box, we will take anything. And all you have to do is put it out in your mailbox, and your mailman will pick it up. Just like your letter carrier, just like they pick up the mail. You don't have to leave, drive, go anywhere. You just have to place your non-perishable items right by your mailbox in either our bag or your bag or whatever kind of container you'd like, and your letter carrier will pick it up on Saturday, May 13th. And it's a real simple thing. And like Joe, what he says, and all this stuff. And this is a nationwide thing, but all this stuff goes back to your own community. Right. You're right, through Help and Harvest, who will distribute it.
Yeah.
I also want to say, we'll take money, too. Cash or checks to Help and Harvest. Because when you donate money also, it's something like, so if you give a buck, then a dollar, that's worth, you can buy $5 worth of food from there.
Right.
So whatever you give is like at least three times
the
more
amount.
The amount. And we had to do that during the pandemic.
Sure.
You know, that was
sure.
So for 2 years, we didn't have,
a
we weren't able to collect food because of safety precautions. But we had, what was it, a donate thing? And
we could donate, and then National would
donate. Our National Union, whatever we got is donations, our National Union would match.
Isn't that great?
Right? So, but we're just so happy to be out there to, pick up the food that you lovely people will donate, We love it. It's a lot of hard work. It makes for a long day, sore backs.
Sure.
But we also
can't do it without our community help. Mm-hmm. That's important.
It's interesting to me what you just said, and I take it for granted sometimes, but it sounds like this has been a project, really, of the rank and file of the union that at least, I'm sure there's support from the Postal Service in some ways, but it's the members, it's the retirees, it's what a service.
And again, Joe, that goes back to like where the eyes and the ears.
You know,
and that's you're exactly right. That's how it started, I think, in 91, and then going forward from 93, the letter carriers recognized the need in their communities for this. More so they started out, and then they talked to the food banks, so it's interesting. In the pantries, like what would be the best time? And the best time, it's on the second Saturday in May for a reason. Sure. And that's because, everybody loves to give during the holidays, Christmas. You get in that spirit, so everybody gives tons. And, try to serve a meal someplace at Christmas time. You can't. But now the cupboards run bare about this time. And everybody forgets about it. So the biggest need to restock the food banks and the pantries is during this time when their supplies get really small. And this is the largest, one-day food drive in the country, by far. And we'll pick up, over the years, we've picked up almost 2 billion, 1.8 or 1.9 billion pounds of food. It's like insane.
It's amazing.
And so that restocks the bank. So what you're really doing is you're getting a bunch of non-perishables, putting in a bag, you're investing in kids. Yeah. You're investing in the future. You're investing in these people who paid their dues, who should not be going hungry.
And it brings people, it's an interesting thing when you talk about numbers like that that are staggering. It brings people together in a country that's sadly divided in so many other areas. Right. Your coworkers, your union has really brought people together from all sectors to help each other and to help communities.
Oh, absolutely. And that's like, this is, hunger does not discriminate.
Right.
Right.
And hunger doesn't have a political party. Hunger is hunger, And that's what's great. We all come together. And actually, like, doing it, it feels like, it's almost like a festive atmosphere. We are so grateful and so happy to do this. I was always taught, if you're grateful, I have a nice job, a nice house, plenty to eat, obviously. Then I was told gratitude's an action verb. So if you're grateful, you better get out there and show it, And we're just like, as mailmen, we all love our customers, And
I appreciate that, because I'm a stamp collector. I mail birthday cards.
That.
Birthday cards. I collect stamps. I mean, the plant stamps just sitting around in my house because I collect them. Every new issue, I get a sheet. And so we have 10 minutes left, and I don't want to leave this meeting without you telling about any job opportunities, career, maybe a little compensation package. Give us a little taste. I mean, you guys are always hiring, right?
Here's what I found online.
So since you guys are always hiring, you're always needing those boots on the ground. Can you tell us a little bit about what you guys do, what kind of job opportunities that may exist, the compensation, anything you want to share with the viewing audience, because everyone's getting older, Richie. I just know that to be true.
Right.
No one's getting any younger. So you've been how long have you been a
letter carrier? Almost 30 years.
Wow,
that's unbelievable.
Ten years.
Wow.
I love my job.
Do you?
Right. So there's career opportunities for those.
Right. So it's like it's a very strange time now, and I remember taking a test with like 1,300 people and hoping to get into the Postal Service, because it was considered a good lifetime job. It still is. Because of the Postal Service and the wages and the benefits that I get, which were bargained for collectively and fought really hard for, by my union, the National Association of Letter Carriers. You know, I'm able to live a really good life, you know, put my kids through school, raise a family, you know, it's one, but everything I have is as a result of the Postal Service. And so that's why Tammy and I still fight to continue that, you know, and it's like just a weird time that everywhere you go, then nobody wants to, I don't know if they don't want to work, but the market out there for a job
it's
is
changed
incredible.
So much. It's changed. And Mike and I have used this in previous shows. We've talked about this. We saw fairly recently something like in the neighborhood of 700,000 public employment job openings throughout this country. So it's everywhere. It's and public employment jobs used to be very hard to get. Yeah. Whether
good, exactly.
Like you're saying, you know, good pay, good benefits. Some you really fought to get one in many cases, and now there's so many places, and it. We often will tell folks, you know, let's talk about the different union jobs that are out here, whether it's trades or private practice or private service or government work, public employment jobs.
Right.
So I'm sure there's, you know, websites and places to go.
Right. If you go on to USPS.com and click on the jobs, right?
Correct. Yep.
I know that for a fact. I couldn't walk you through it because I haven't had to apply.
Right.
So we've had, like Tammy says, we love our, as mailmen, we love our jobs. Yeah, it's nothing like we want to be out on the street, interacting with our customers, bringing them there. Like during the pandemic, we brought them their necessities.
I bet.
You know, we like to bring these the Vietnam vets and the older vets too, their medicine. You know, and they're all happy to see.
Yep.
And bring the kids their Easter card from their. Grandmom across the country, you know, that's thrilling. it actually is, you know. And we love our customers, and we do anything for them. And this is one thing we do for our customers.
I bet Tammy, especially, and I know Richie has said you may have not been delivering as recently. I'm not sure what year you said you stopped, but still working. You were delivering through this pandemic, like you were talking about.
She was working 80 hours a week
and
Sundays.
I bet. There were so many seniors who were homebound that you were the highlight of their day.
We, as Richie said, we are the eyes and ears of the community, so we see everything, and we played an important part of their day. Even if it was a 2-minute conversation, hi, how are you?
And I know it. My own mother passed in June, but my parents loved to use the mail service. They loved this. My father doesn't even like to put his envelopes, he likes to take them to the post office.
Right.
Even at 84 and not getting around is great. But they love to get that mail.
During the pandemic, because we could take them their medicine. Yep. Maybe it was groceries. Maybe it was a case of water.
Yep.
Maybe it was, you know, toilet paper or paper towels.
We'd like to thank you on behalf of our union and on behalf of AFL-CIO and the labor community for what you've done. Really, it's overlooked so easily, but you guys really were the heroes to do that for folks.
Thanks, they certainly were.
Yep.
I certainly want to echo that. Now, we're in the last 5 minutes here, so I want you to give us one more pep talk and pitch for this 31st year nationwide food drive, more food collected in one day on the planet.
On the planet.
Correct.
Right, we're going to be just not here. We're going to be in 10,000 cities and towns across the country, every single state, along with the Virgin Islands, Puerto Rico, Guam. And we're going to be out there. You're going to get this in the mail, a little card. You're going to tend to throw it away. I'm going to ask our viewing audience, hey, you know what? Take this. You see food, feed families. Stick it on your refrigerator so you don't forget. I know you like to throw it in the trash. Then a day or two later, you're going to get one of these in the mail. A bag in the mail, and we're asking you to put your non-perishable items in there. We will, your mailman or letter carrier, I shouldn't say mailman, your letter carrier, right, Tim?
Correct.
We'll pick it up.
Politically correct.
Along with your mail, when they deliver the mail, and that's all you have to do. You don't
Or you may see people driving around picking up the food. It may not only be your carrier, because we have probably
like
30
I'll be
volunteers.
Driving around picking up the food. Please, if you see me on porch, don't shoot me. You know, the green hairs left over from St. Patty's Day, which I have a hard time of letting go of. You know how that goes, Mike, right?
I do.
Yeah,
I do.
So, you know, because it seems nowadays you go up on someone's porch, you get shot. You know what I mean? So that's a whole other show.
This is, I don't even know, you may know this from chairing this and working all these years. How many boots on the ground for this day? And they're not just on the ground, because they're wherever you're taking the food. I can't even believe the size of the operation. But how many volunteers do you think you have that day here in Berks?
With the letter carriers, there'll be probably about 400 of us out there.
Wow.
Does that sound about right?
Probably.
Yep. And then another,
and then
like
whatever Helping Harvest has as volunteers.
Helping Harvest will have it. It's like
drivers.
A well-oiled machine.
Isn't that something?
The
mailman will pack up a lot of the food at the post, each individual post office, the Helping Harvest will send trucks down, and then there's volunteers.
They have volunteers.
At the Helping Harvest.
You take for granted how these big operations happen, but 500-600 people in Berks doing something to help others, what a day.
Right, we have to turn volunteers away sometimes.
Isn't
that's
that
how
something?
Popular this is. So again, I just want to say, May 13th, it's always the Saturday before Mother's Day. Your mailman will be picking up non-perishable items that you put out in one of these bags. Hopefully you will, provided by Visions, Federal Credit Union, that you will get in the mail. And we ask that you please, you know, help your community out, your brothers and sisters. And this food is going to go to the most vulnerable people, our future, you know, which is the young children in our past, which is the seniors,
exactly.
Right?
Well, I want to thank both of our guests here. Now, this is the Spanish version, and then they got the English right below us. We just really want to talk this up here, this food drive. And we have national partners here, the AFL-CIO, the Kellogg's, United Way, CVS Health. I mean, this is the hugest food drive. And so, you know, Joe, I think we have about 30 seconds left here. I just want to remind our viewer audience that we do have a picnic coming up on May 6th. Mm-hmm. And again, I want to thank our guest here.
And I want to say, don't forget to vote May 16th.
That's right.
Forget out there and get the vote.
That's
May 1st
right.
is your last day to register.
There you go.
Please get out there to vote.
Absolutely.
Very good.
This is... It's so important.
And I want to thank Tammy also as our political liaison, who does a lot of hard work there, our food drive coordinator. And that's what she does in her spare time besides working 80 hours a week to do
the right thing.
We're so honored to have her.
I appreciate it.
Thank you.
This was
thank
fun.
You very much. And Joe, final words?
Well,
seconds left.
Just feeling, I feel grateful to have people like you two representing so many hundreds of others in Berks who are given so much. So thank you.
Thank you for having us, and thanks for what you do.
Yep.
Thank you. Hey, we'll see you next month. Workers in Berks, big shout out here to the National Association of Letter Carriers and Stamp Out Hunger, the second Saturday of May, 31st year. Thank you and good night.
Workers in Berks is supported by Southeastern PA Area Labor Federation.